cremation building. Number two, cement roof of an underground morgue, alleged to have been a human gas chamber where hundreds of thousands were murdered in 1943-44. Almost all supposed eyewitnesses described watching SS men drop cyanide gas pellets through roof vents onto victims. Number three, two holes inspected by the author in 1993 are not visible on 1944 air photos. So they were knocked through the roof after 1944 by someone attempting to make the roof coincide with important eyewitness stories. Hole number one on the left and hole number two on the right. I entered the morgue through hole number one. Number four, four marks on the August 25th, 1944 air photos. My 1993 camp inspection inside and outside the roof showed there were never any holes at these locations. So the four air photo marks were not holes. Whether the marks were drawn on the photos, as I believe, or whether they were shadows from objects on the roof, does not change the important fact that the four marks were not holes. Number five, conclusions. Eyewitnesses describe watching pellets being dropped through roof holes. However, the location of the four marks on the August 25th, 1944 air photos have today no holes, and therefore they were not holes in 1944. The only two holes in the roof today have no corresponding marks in the 1944 air photos. Therefore, they were knocked through the roof after 1944, and therefore the roof had no holes in 1944, making eyewitness stories of cyanide pellets being poured through roof vents physically impossible.